How's everybody doing tonight?
Good.
Yeah. All we need to get started from you guys is a word.
Kamikaze.
Okay, good one.
So kamikaze reminds me of the first time in college I engaged in the culturally inappropriate practice of sake bombing at a bar. Sake bombing, for those who don't know, is where you get a small cup of sake and a large cup of beer and you drop it and then you like, drink it really fast. So I did this with three of my teammates when we were on the rowing team the day before we did a ropes course as a team bonding activity. And all of us were in pretty bad shape, but we had to at one point like overcome this like spiderweb type thing where we had to like pass people up through it, and we were like quite high off the ground and you know like anchored in. But it was a really bad moment to not have an excellent command of one's balance. But all three of us, four of us, like made it through, and we said that that was without question the hardest part of the entire rowing season was like that experience. But we did it.
So kamikaze makes me think of a time when I was in 10th grade. God, I hope I haven't told the story before the show. When we had an interdisciplinary project, it was a week long, we were reenacting the 1948 election.
You've not told the story before.
And I was chosen to be Harry Truman, and there was like another campaign and like the press and people playing different experts and Emperor Hirohito, and we had to reenact the whole thing and have press conferences and debates and all this stuff, and it was very exciting, it was very intense. At one point the other team's, or maybe it was our team's, email account got hacked into, for which responsibility was never claimed. At one point each campaign recorded dueling music videos. So I think theirs was to the tune of that like you're so 2000 and late song, you know what I'm saying? And ours was Baby Got Back, transformed into Bring Truman Back. Hey. Me rapping, possibly offensive things about the atomic bomb, in a YouTube video that is still publicly available.
Adventures, I'm going to go off of that. That makes me think about, I went to a weird college that only had two extramural sports, and they, well three, there were fencing, crew, and croquet, and we had these intramural sports games between like various people at the school, and as you might guess from a school that didn't have a lot of sports teams, like it was fairly gentle, like not a whole lot of like competitive spark. But somehow these intramural basketball games would just like bring out the fire in people. And because I filled out my work study paperwork late, I ended up with my last choice, which was being a gym assistant. And most of the time it was pretty awesome because I would sit at the front desk, like occasionally tell people to take their shoes off. We had like a new street shoes in the gym policy. And but most people already knew that anyway, so you know it didn't really come into play that much, so I'd just be sitting there doing my homework. And sometimes the athletic director would be there and he would make me score these intramural games. And I have never been yelled at so many times in the course of 1 2-minute interval when I did not keep track of fouls properly. So gentle indie rock liberal arts students becoming furious.
Excellent.
I can't imagine being a fencing kid.
Oh my god, I know. Like, the outfits?
The outfits?
Like, you know, the masks.
You have to, like, hit people?
Yeah. Also, I have no respect for varsity fencing. Varsity croquet is where it's at.
Like, so many other weird schools have varsity fencing programs. One of the great schools have a varsity croquet program.
Right? Like, first of all, our Mad Hatter Tea Party costumes, sorry, uniforms, are legit.
Yeah.
Okay.
And our funny little things that we hit the ball through, whatever they're called, that I'm blanking on right now, they're pretty cool too.
Yeah, those wickets. Fucking awesome.
That's right. Wicked name.
take all of the rage that you have in your heart, you channel it to the stick, and then you tap in responsibly with strategy.
You channel your rage into precision.
Precision! And discipline. Okay? I mean, do you remember during Hell Week when we had to carry all of our mallets up and down the country club steps? Exhausting.
And people were snickering behind our back, being like, oh, crib cane is such a lame sport. Well, they don't know.
They don't know.
Fancy kids are really cool. No.
Yeah.
You don't come home sweating from practice. Okay.
Also, like, they don't even actually stab each other. Okay? Right. You know that.
They
right?
think they're so hardcore.
Right.
They're not.
But it's like, oh, we're going to, like, poke. And, like, that's. Yeah. Yeah. Whereas, like, if I wanted to do some real damage with this mallet, yeah, I could.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice backswing, by the way.
Full golf.
But you gotta do something first to earn it. You gotta haze a fencing kid.
Okay. It's a show.
It's just that I'm not really much of a rapper. And I do want to win the election.
Madam President, you will lose re-election if you do not rap. Every poll we've taken shows this.
It just doesn't feel very, worldly to sing of any sort on the campaign trail.
Listen, your optics are terrible.
I know, and the affair didn't help.
You're seen as stodgy.
Yeah.
You had an affair.
As I mentioned, way to rub it in.
You're 36 years old. A lot of youth voters view you as too old to run again.
It's only because I'm a woman. If I was a man, nobody would care that I was 36.
I could not be more, Madam President, but you need to appear youthful by doing the rap.
So what?
We've secured the rights to three different rap songs.
Which ones are they?
For you to parody.
Okay.
We picked your three favorite rap songs that you know.
My favorite, Vanilla Ice.
Yes.
Yeah. How would that even go? I want your vote, baby.
Okay, that's a great start. That's a great start.
I feel ridiculous. I mean, I have a JD from Yale. I feel like that should stand on its own.
That doesn't go viral.
Is that what politics has come down to?
Yes. We hired a rhythm coach to help you get into the groove.
Yeah. If you want to just follow along with me. Oh, you're adding something. Oh, yeah.
She's original.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. Madam President, why don't you freestyle?
Did she just call me Vice President? I feel incredibly insubordinate.
I'm so sorry. I have been told that you'll be demoted on the ticket if you don't vote.
I need your vote, baby.
There we go. That'll work.
That was the hardest thing I've had to do in college.
Oh, and it's
fly, right?
Well, I mean, people do fly, like, airplanes.
Yeah, well,
we still grow the humans.
That's fine. Yeah, but I mean, yeah. He's not, the bird was way better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's like in a machine, in a contraption to do it.
Right,
like,
right.
The bird just lifts its wings and it's up.
Yeah.
And fish, they're just like underwater without breathing.
Yeah.
So,
like that one.
Oh, okay, it's not humans who don't know how to swim.
Then they have a whole sport built around them like eating worms with hooks on them, so, you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, we're smarter than them, but somehow they have the kind of street knowledge. What do you call it?
I don't know.
They
don't
yeah.
go on streets.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I'm sure they could word it better than this, but yeah, they, practical. Yeah,
instinct.
Yeah, we just lost all of our instinct when we started studying Hegel and synthesis and hypothesis and all this stuff.
So that brings me to my idea.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We dropped out.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
Hey, pilots, everybody get in here. Strap in. As you know, this may be a kamikaze mission. We may not be coming back.
I'm so excited.
So, whoa. Okay.
Oh, something.
So excited!
Is your whole life okay?
Yeah. What's up, Bill?
Hey, I didn't even mean to make this about me. I just, you know, things have been hard, and Cheryl left, and.
Oh, she did?
Yeah, but like, you want to die?
I'm just excited for the mission. You said we might die. That's exciting.
But we're super gonna die. That's what I told him.
We all got into this for glory of country, not to escape our wives.
Well, I'm not trying to escape her. She escaped me.
I feel like we can't take off with this.
And now I want to escape me.
Do you need a therapist recommendation? Because I see a great guy.
We're dying in 5 minutes.
Well,
all of us,
maybe,
together.
Maybe.
I don't know. But, you know what, maybe, can everyone like, who's not going like, huddle up for a second and talk about this? Like,
I guess, like, are we, like, the only people that watch it or something?
broadcasting from Oprah's own network, Alternative Sports. So what you want to do is, you want to, you can get multiple balls, and you can take that mallet and really whack them, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I can do? Run people through.
I'm just not interested. Click.
Shit, dead air!
So you're saying my patients won't respect me if I don't dance?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
You know Dr. Mike, the TikTok influencer?
Yeah.
Really hot, but also smart and thoughtful, and provides like comprehensive medical diagnoses.
Right.
So that is already filled. So you can't do that. Right?
Okay.
So I'm thinking, maybe like a quick, how about a polka? Can you?
A polka?
Yeah. Yeah.
The kids are into polka?
Yeah, it's a retro thing. You know, they're all named like, Seamus and Nathaniel and like biblical names. They're into the old stuff too. Yeah, so go ahead. Just,
So we don't have any patients on the book today? So
I have to go. I cleared the whole afternoon.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't even know what a polka looks like.
We don't actually have a rhythm guy that we hire.
Great. Let's try to unify medical practice. Oh,
yeah.
Rhythm guy.
Well, he's really in high demand.
Yeah. I can't tell you who else I've worked for, but you would know. Right. Okay. Are you ready? I'm just gonna give you a little rhythm and you kind of riff on it.
Yeah.
He's
awesome.
Not
riffing.
Now do that with your lips.
Okay.
He's not really riffing though.
Good. Doctor, maybe it feels like we're having some sort of like a really itchy leg and you're trying to like shake it off. Like that might.
Like if I had psoriasis?
Sure. There we go.
There's an idea.
competitive Kegels. It's like
that's exclusionary.
Don't worry about that. Yes, and that's
legal.
No, anyone can do it. It's the same thing, just different holes.
Yeah.
It works.
Okay. The competitive philosophy debate begins now. We have one Hegelian scholar, and we have another. Keep in mind, though philosophy is intellectual, this competition will be mostly physical.
Phenomenology of this spirit.
Say that again?
The phenomenology of this spirit is coming at you now.
I believe that everything is nothing and nothing is everything. I'm coming for you.
That's because you live in a cave and you just look at shadows.
Okay, well, I'm sorry, Professor, I'm just going to step in to remind you, you have to get out from behind the microphones to physically fight.
Okay.
If you wanted to just shout philosophy at each other, we could have a department meeting.
Monads all over the building. They will be here to devour your souls imminently. Go.
I'm grateful that the monads are gonna like me better than you.
I am terrified that I'm gonna die. I wasn't prepared for this to happen today.
I love monads.
Do not touch the monads. So what I said, you get one of those fencers, okay? And then what you do is, you embarrass them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, hey. Hey, nice.
Thank you so much.
That was a joke.
Oh!
We got owned by a croquet kid. It has a taste.
No. Something more, like, you know,
but fencing is so lame, I should point it out. That's just...
I'm an Olympic athlete. So I have to do a little better.
No, no, don't be like...
Okay, I can't be impressed right
now. But wait, did you like... Did you win a medal?
Did you win a medal?
I came fourth.
So no. Okay.
And that's our show.